So you join me, we're tackling fiero issues. So what we're doing right now is we're getting a tack gauge that is hunting around everywhere. So my plan is we ordered a new circuit board online. So this is gonna take the place of this. We also had down here that little ground or supply, I think that was not functioning properly. Like it wasn't bolted on all the way. So that might've been part of the issue with this reading so high. So we're gonna take this apart and we're gonna put it back together and hope that that fixes the issue. So I put the new board in, which wasn't too much of a pain. It didn't have a place for a screw down here to tighten it down like the old one did, but it should be fine with just the two. We also have an issue where the door adjacent or the door ajar bulb likes to stay on. So we're just gonna go ahead while we're in here, take that out. All right, I'll never get over how empty what kind of race car looks without everything up here. It's kind of fun. So we got to reconnect all this stuff into that to get this operational. Of course there's problems. So the parking brake in the back was giving me issues. So I'm trying to adjust it and get this thing working appropriately so that it works. And hopefully now we're getting a bit of drag on it, so we're gonna have to play around and see what's going on. So what I found was that when I got the car or this whole rear setup, there was no springs in here, and it was a easy thing to overlook. So I put the spring in here, as you can see, and that pushes this out, and that helps. There's a little gear in here rotate, and I'll show you exactly, because it's hard to do. I wanted to get one side together before I show you, so let me go show you the other side. So as you can see on this side, when you go back here, I'm trying to do this with one hand, so it's a little hard, apologize. But you can see there's no spring back inside here. So there's supposed to be a tension spring that pushes this up so that the parking brake can clock. So think of this in here, there's like a little ratcheting system up here in this bolt. And if that ratchet doesn't ever click, and all you're doing is kind of applying pressure on, you know, one spot. So it doesn't really work. Now, there is an awful lot of drag on the brake here, but we can adjust that with the tensioner over there once we get these hooked up and put the spring hook back in. So here's how I tackle getting the spring back on there. So zip ties and some pliers and just get this down. Wear eye protection because this thing wants to fly. This thing is under a lot of pressure. So you go in here, and like I said, you tighten this down. Where is it at? It's kind of hard to do this. Like this. Oh, this is tight spaces. So right in here, let me see, hold on. Ah, that works better. So this is the nut you need to drive in while holding the nut out so that the whole thing clocks in properly and you don't lose that. This here is where the spring needs to go because this handle, see if I can do this without blocking the screen. This, when it compresses, activates the brake and I can hear it, but then when it comes, it needs to be pushed out so that the ratchet mechanism can click back and forth so it can keep pressure on this bit on the brake cylinder. Otherwise the whole thing is pointless. So I got that in, so we'll see how this works. This is my first time pulling on this. Oh, that just feels so much better. Ah, it's supposed to do that. If you don't know, that's how it works. It can get in and out. Look at that. And then, okay, let's try. Hard to do with one hand. So you take, you push in, you go up here, you push in the thing, and then you let it down. You go all the way down with it, and then those springs, yeah, they're fully released. So, yep, so lift and press, down and release. Then hopefully we can tell when the car starts. We should be able to do it here. No brake light, and then it should come on as soon as we, yes. All right, perfect. Oh, now we just gotta see if it holds on a hill. Well, I was gonna show you how I did a homemade alignment, but the thing, I just moved it and it broke. So those numbers over there mean stuff. Hopefully they're still good because I can't check now. So yay. Basically the front left wheel seemed like it was towing out, like it was towing in towards the center here, according to my measurements. And the back one was towing out. So we adjusted that and adjusted that according to the math there. We did it 20 millimeters in the front and 9 millimeters in the back, but I have no idea how good that is because moving that stuff, I broke it. So, yay. But we're going to take it out for a test drive with the new oil and everything in it and see how well it worked out. Lovely 3D printed cup holder appears to work pretty good. It seems like it's held down pretty good. So here we are on a slight hill. Pull up the parking brake, make sure it's fully engaged. Oh. Helps if you're not in gear. And yeah, we're sliding back. So that's not good. Still something to fix. I've never had to deal with these cicadas before and they give me the jimmies. Ah, they're so creepy. I don't know if you can see that. Look at that guy. Ugh. Oh, I'll be happy when this is over. In the meantime, wrapping and wrapping the exhaust because it gets hot under the hood or the deck lid there. So, working on that. In case you're wondering, header pipe. These have actually been supposedly ported to match the hole. Probably, who knows. This is our little mid pipe and that's our exhaust there. Like the that comes down from the pipe, goes around and then out like that. And then we're gonna just put all this back together. I wanted to wrap the muffler because it kind of still sits in the engine bay, but I wasn't sure if it would fit back up in there once I do that. So they make a product to actually wrap that whole thing. And we might actually just cut this out and put in a better muffler anyway. So I don't really wanna mess with that right now. So it's got two little hangers on each side. I made up of all these springs and we'll just put it back in using those because it's a lot easier and safer than trying to de-hook all those springs, because if one of those flies off and catches you in the eye, it's a terrible day. I don't know if safety glasses would do great against those anyway. Well, that's not good as we get ready for Carlisle. Coolant leaking out. Why could that be? Why? It's because this has got a cut in it from something. I don't know what that could be from. This isn't close enough to be touching it. So, I don't know. But we need a new pipe there. So we're gonna have to get a new one of these. We got a lot of pipe bits left, but I don't have any connectors for it. So we're gonna have to find those. Coolant tube back in. Car works, we took it for a ride. It's doing good. Well, we gotta do some shakedowns on it so we're ready for Carlisle. That'll be next video. I'm gonna end it here because I don't have any idea how long this is gonna be. So you can see we got oil pressure, the temp is fine, we're good on voltage. And it sounds good. Oh yeah, so I readjusted the parking brake too. You can see, kind of barely it's on. Car's in gear, it's in reverse, back up. Can't feel that, but we're not going anywhere. Parking brake off, foot off the clutch, and we're going.